Hi, this is a video on two types of data. In this chapter, we're going to be looking at collecting data and also how to visualize that data. So we're going to start with two types. If you need this worksheet, you can get it on my website at caraleemath.com. And let's look at our two types of data. The first one is quantitative or numerical. The second one is qualitative or categorical. I will probably switch back and forth between those terms. Different books use different terms. They mean the exact same thing, as far as quantitative means the same as numerical, and qualitative means the same as categorical. So for each one, let's look at a description, some examples, and then the types of graphs that we'll use to display the data. Quantitative, as you can probably tell, is numerical, meaning the data will be numerical values. So the data are numbers with units. It's usually something we're measuring or asking. An example could be, let's say we measured everyone's heart rate. Heart rate would be measured in beats per minute, BPM. Another one might be weight. If it was weight, we would probably measure it in pounds in the US, kilograms in another country. Types of graphs that we have, we're going to look at histograms and box plots. Box plots will be a little bit later, but these two go together. We often will make these two graphs for the same set of data so that we can compare. And then the third one that we'll look at for types of graphs is called a time series plot. Now this only works if you have XY data. You need an X coordinate and a Y coordinate, and the X coordinate would be the time. So here you have two variables. These are both one variable. You can get a single variable, collect data on a single variable, such as heart rate, and make a histogram or a box plot. And I'll be showing you those soon in another video. Let's switch over to the qualitative. You can probably guess from the name that these are categories. So the data are categories or groups. One way I remember this is qualitative, it has the word, or is close to the word, quality. So we're recording some type of quality about someone, a category, a group, or a quality, versus a quantity, which would be a number. An example for this would be, let's say we want to ask someone a question. It could be a yes-no type of a question. For example, have you ever been evicted from your housing? That would be a yes or no. It doesn't have a number associated with it, so that's qualitative data. So it could be a question. Have you been evicted? Another example would be grade level. Let's say K through 12, for example. I want to use this example because there actually are numbers. Sometimes you can have a number representing a category. So let's say in K through 12, so your grade level, not your grade level because you're in college, but someone's grade level would start from K, 1, 2, 3, dot, 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 all the way up to 11 or 12. If someone put their grade level of 11, then that's a category versus being a quantitative variable. So sometimes we have to really look at a variable and decide if it is a number, if we want it to be a qualitative or a quantitative variable. One way I use to tell is, would we average the numbers together? Would we average people's grade levels together? If so, it might be quantitative. If we would not average them together, say for zip code or area code, it wouldn't make sense to average those together. So those would be qualitative variables. Now we have two types of graphs that we can use for qualitative variables, and they are bar graphs and pie charts. Okay, so that's our two types of variables, and we'll look at graphing those in future videos. Thanks for watching.